Hey, what's up, dudes? This is Johnny Bean. We're live. It's April 4th, 2024. It's 10.06 p.m. Eastern, 7.06 Pacific, right? Out here in Santa Cruz, California. You guys, we're going to talk about Randy Rhoads today. We're going to do a new series called Diary of a Guitar Man. And if you like Randy Rhoads, subscribe to the channel. Hang out with us. It's going to be a good time. So let's do this. This is Johnny Bean TV.
Hi, this is Alex Skolnick, and you're watching Johnny Bean TV.
Yo, there we are. Right on, dude.
Bet.
Laz,
hello,
Lazzy, Lazborn, what's going on, man? What's going on? Man, this is...
Looks like he's driving to the train station.
Yo, you hear me? Can you hear me, man? What's going on?
I.
What's going on, dude?
I've got the only good internet. I'm rolling on the highway.
Uh-huh. Very cool. Right on. Well, hey, we got Laz. We got Ron Gunner. Hey, man.
Hello, everybody.
How are you doing tonight?
I'm here and I'm not floating around. So
very cool. Right
everybody on. Around me is, but I'm lucky where I'm at.
Oh, yeah. You guys, I'm in Santa Cruz, California. Laz, he's gone. He's I don't know what happened.
He went away.
He went away, but he'll be back. Ron, where are you Where are you hanging out?
I am in Shadyside, Ohio, and every city and town around me is pretty much underwater right now. The Ohio River is over its bank. Wheeling Island is underwater. Wheeling Island Casino and Racetrack is underwater.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm doing pretty good.
Dang. Laz, there you are. We got you back, man. Cool. Well, hey,
you hear me all right?
We hear you, man. We hear you. And you guys, so if this is your first time here, let's just do that for a minute. Okay, yeah, he's on the phone now. You guys, if this is your first time here, my name's Johnny Bean, and I do a lot of Van Halen related shows. I do a show called Exclusively Van Halen Tuesdays, 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific. And I know my internet is like really bad right now, but that's okay as long as you guys can hear me. But our friend Ron here is a huge fan of Randy Rhoads, so we're gonna talk some Randy Rhoads tonight. We're gonna talk about the guitars, the music, the albums. Any questions or comments you guys have in the chat, feel free. But before we start here, we're live on YouTube, and on YouTube we have channel members, and we like to give a shout out to the top tier of channel members. They are currently Sherman Callahan, CC, Nova 9, Michael Smith, Music Therapy, Laz, there you are, Arhabs, Warlag, Fairfield Guitar Co., Majestic PB and J Cat, and Janice Lala. Thank you guys for your continued support for the channel and for these shows. Let's get Laz back in here. Laz, there you are, man.
Yo, what's up?
Hey, okay. So how do you guys wanna, Ron? Do you wanna take it from here?
Sure. All right, everybody. I've been begging Johnny for a long time, more or less, and hinting about doing a show, him and I together doing a show about Randy Rhoads. I do not know Eddie Van Halen like a lot of you guys do, and I've learned a lot in coming up on a year now of, you know, with doing the shows with Johnny, and I don't know how long I've been doing, 6 months, I think I've been doing the Van Halen shows. Learned a lot, and then I know that, you know, you look at Randy, you look at Eddie, you look at George Lynch, you know, that was that group back then. Mm-hmm. And I knew Johnny didn't know a lot about Randy, so I thought I could return the favor and get him info on Randy and talk about the man, you know, who really inspired me. So
nice, man. Yeah. Yeah. And just, so you guys, so I'll admit, I'm a fan of Ozzy Osbourne, Randy Rhoads, but I'm mostly a Van Halen guy. So I really don't know. Like, you guys can ask me anything in the chat about Van Halen. Make sure that's on Tuesdays, 8 p.m. Eastern, right here on Johnny Bean YouTube, Twitch, and Facebook pages. But as far as the Randy Rhoads stuff, I think, we do have some, Ron, you did write out a list of the guitars that Randy used.
Mm-hmm.
Really nice list here. So we'll talk about the guitars, and I think just some of the history of Randy and just the entire.
And you want the giveaway?
We do giveaways on the channel here.
Yeah, here it is.
Nice.
What do we have? Oh, cool.
Oh, I love it. That's killer. Oh, nice. Yeah, very cool.
So this is the giveaway tonight. Somebody can win this.
Oh, Ron. Oh, my God.
Except for Laz. Laz can't win it. He's on the show.
Well, that's all right. Somebody else can win it. I'm happy to be on the show. Yeah. Randy was one of my favorites, too, actually. You know, from back in the day, I was really, not that I wasn't impressed by Edward Van Halen, because obviously he was playing it, you know. When Randy hit the scene, that style of kind of metal, classical kind of thing, that was like pre-neoclassical, I think Randy brought like this flavor of guitar playing that was different than anything you heard. Just like what Edward Van Halen did. Edward did something that nobody ever heard before, and that's what Randy did as well. That's what makes them uniquely similar, I'd have to say.
Very true.
Yeah.
And it may be again because of the time frame and location, there obviously was a created rivalry, I guess I want to say, even though I personally don't see it, because night and day, two different styles. You know, Eddie had his sound and Randy had the classical thing going. And you had, you know, you just had like the two biggest kids on the block, you know, right there. So there's bound to be comparisons. But I think it was all done in fun. It's not like they ever got into a knockdown, drag out argument or anything over it. So, but again, it was completely two different styles. So
I think as peers, they probably definitely respected each other for sure.
Oh, I'm sure they did. For, you know, just for pure talent alone. You know, when you're on that level and there's someone that you're being compared to, whether it was Eddie to Randy or Randy to Eddie, you know, they're both, whoever's doing that's putting you up on top of that ladder. So you got to have some kind of mutual respect there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I mean, I can't even imagine what it would have been like back in the day going to those shows, seeing mm-hmm. both bands in the clubs. And seeing, you know, both these guys. And I mean, I can see why people think, you know, they're similar or there has to be one that's better or whatever. I mean, I can see that.
Mm-hmm.
But also just imagine back in the clubs back then or later, all the guitar players that were spawned because of those two guys, because of Edward and Randy.
And even
George. Yeah. Definitely. Very influential.
And George Lynch, yeah.
Yeah. You know, that's just... And the sad part, again, I've said this before, I was there in 78. I could have went to the Starwood and saw Quiet Riot and did not go.
Dang.
I've kicked myself ever since that. So.
Could you get in? Because what I heard is when they played, everyone flocked to those shows, and it just was crazy.
Yeah,
like they packed every place they played.
My cousin had an in with someone at the Starwood, so getting in wouldn't have been a problem.
Oh man, you should have gone. Yeah.
I know.
The first time did you see them like in Blizzard or did you see them for Diary?
No, I had tickets to see them for the Diary of a Madman tour. He died about a month before I was going to be able to see him.
So. Yeah, because they were on their way your direction. They had left from where I was living in Denver, and I saw them at the CU Event Center in Boulder. And there was such a big storm that a lot of their set wasn't available. They were actually offering to give people money back if they wanted to leave and come for a future show. And some people left. Not everyone. It was, I'd say, 3/4 still full. But we waited nearly an hour and a half or more. I mean, it was worse than waiting for, you know, what's his name from Guns N' Roses to show up there, the thing. But it was because their set
Axel.
Was... Axel, that's the guy's name. I'm just messing around. But actually, he did really good when Bama's warmed up for him. But I got to say, man, that show, they really put it on because they knew everybody waited. It was a storm for us, too. We were going to be driving back to the Denver area, you know, 70-plus miles away in that same snowstorm where they're going to go right into a hotel. So they wanted to put on the best show that they could, you know, and they didn't have all the Dire and Madman castle set with the cages and all that. So it was just them and their equipment, and they killed it, man. It was amazing. You know, where he lifts up Randy when Randy's playing thing, the whole thing. I mean, yeah.
Iconic.
And he had the polka dot B. He had the polka dot B then, didn't he? I recall that. I'm pretty sure he had the Sandoval B. You know, the other thing I wanted, because I know I'm going to have to leave shortly and then come back later, but the other commonality that they had is they both early on worked with someone on custom guitars out of the Charvel world, in the sense that Grover Jackson took over Charvel's, you know, basically manufacturing and all. And and he was the one who pissed off Eddie by selling the you know, Bumblebee striped guitars, from what I understand. And that's why Eddie broke it off with them. But same guys, you know, basically were putting together the guitars early on, or at least parts for, and building guitars for both of the guitarists that became two of the, at that time, there was nobody outside of maybe that when Yngwie showed up that had such a hit on the, like, the culture of rock music. Everyone was like, whoa, who's this guy? You know, maybe Steve Vai, but yeah, at that time, right, it was those two, and then maybe Yngwie. And of course, you know, when Ozzy had to replace Randy, he had a pretty good, you know, second fiddle in a sense.
Oh, yeah.
You know, because I saw them for the Bark of the Moon tour as well. Ozzy's hair was, you know, halfway grown back. And Motley Crue warmed up for them. And that was, man, when they were first hit the scene, they were red hot. Just like,
oh, my gosh. Lazzy, I didn't know you'd seen so many cool shows, man.
Oh, dude, I've seen back in the day, man. I saw lots of shows. Yeah, a lot of good shows.
Are you on your way back from a show right now?
No, I wish I was.
Are you on your way to a show right now?
I wish I was. I'm on my way home to your show where I can join from my room, we call it, the Flying Pickle Production Studio.
Cool.
Anyway.
Cool, right on, man. Dude, I can't believe this. I can't believe you saw Randy Rhoads live, man.
Yeah, I saw him live, man. And the amazing thing to me is I wonder what those people felt after they heard he died, that, you know, opted to leave and come back for a future possible show and not get to see him again. It's like, can you imagine that?
Yeah, and what gets me is the death was so unnecessary. Oh. It's not like they were flying to a show. It was a stupid plane trip that should have never happened from a pilot that should have never been flying. So.
Wasn't the story that the reason he got up in the plane in the first place is because I think the costume coordinator girl or whatever,
Rachel Youngblood,
she was afraid to go, and so
she
went.
Had a heart issue.
He went with her to kind of, you know, make her feel better.
Yep, and he took his camera because he wanted to take some aerial pictures to send to
her. Oh, my God. So. I wonder if that film has ever been developed.
I don't know. The plane completely engulfed in flames and burnt
everything,
that's true. So I'm sure
it's
ruined.
Out of the house or something like that, right? Crazy.
Man.
Yeah. But you know, on to more, you know, I'd like to say some more positive things. I mean, really, Randy and Eddie both had an interesting, similar kind of rise. You know, they were both from struggling families. His mom, Randy's mom, you know, got divorced from the dad. They originally built this home where they were going to, you know, have that school, which they did. And growing up, you know, from the early 70s on, Randy was, you know, exposed to David Bowie and Alice Cooper and stuff like that. And that's what got him wanting to get into rock and roll and not just be like a flamenco or classical guitar player or teacher. And I think it was him and his brother or something that played the drums for them for a while.
Kelly, he was in a band with
them. Yeah, before. What was the name of their band before? Something like the Foxtrots or some kind of Velvet Fox.
Yep.
And then they came up with a different band name after that, but then they changed it to Quiet Riot. I can't remember what it was.
It was Little Women.
Little Women.
Yep, Little Women, yeah. And then it got changed to Quiet Riot. Actually, it's just Quite Right. And then
I heard that it was Quite Right. They were joking around about Quite Right because British had to talk. That's Quite Right.
Quite Right was the band?
Yeah, it was Quite Right. Then it became Quite Right.
And they were joking about we should call it Quite Right, and they're like, no, how about Quiet Riot? And they're like, yeah, that's even funnier. Quite Right. So, a great band name.
Okay, wow. So anybody want to get into about the guitars?
Yeah.
No, I sent Johnny a bunch of pictures. All right.
Of the guitars.
Of the guitars, yeah.
Lots of guitars.
Cool. Well, hey, let's say hello. Let's say hello. Let's say hello to some people here. Let's see. We got Chuck. Is that it? Is that the band name?
Yeah.
We got Chuck. Chuck is here. We got Lewis. Hey, dude. We got Ian. Wouldn't the car be going backwards if you were being towed? Or they tow them from the front now too?
Oh, they do.
If it's front wheel drive, they got towed from the front.
Mine would go up on a truck, so it would be just like this up on a truck because I'm an all wheel drive. All four, baby.
Are you in the Franken van right now?
No, but I do have the Franken van back, and I'll take you guys on a little trip on that maybe next week.
What you need to do is make one side of it stripe and the other side polka dot.
Oh,
damn, dude, that's an awesome idea. I love that.
Oh,
dude.
Man.
Oh, man, now you're talking. Yeah, I like it.
Cool. We got Noel. Hey, man. Let's see. We got Peggy saying, Ron, you should have went to the gig.
Yeah, I know. I've kicked myself ever since.
Dude, that's a tough one.
Well, I'm almost home, you guys, so I got to ditch. I'll be back in like 20.
Okay.
I'm going to miss the guitars. I'm going to have to watch the rerun.
Okay, cool.
All right, I'll be back later.
All right, bye-bye.
I'll be back.
Hit the leave button.
You got to go before you can come back. There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wish I would have went now. I really do.
Dude, that's tough. That's a tough one. I mean, with like Laz, the guy that was just driving the car, he never saw Van Halen live, you know, and we talk Van Halen all the time. And, you know, I saw Van Halen many times and I was lucky enough to meet Edward and, but it's just a tough one when you have one of your favorite bands ever and you could have gone, you could have seen them, whatever, and you didn't. Yep. And then when it's too late, you can't.
Yep, never can.
And that's tough, man.
I know.
Let's see. Let's read some comments, though.
That happened to me twice. I didn't go see Randy when I could have, and I had tickets to go see Dime the night he got shot.
And I had
to work over. I didn't get to go.
Dude.
So, you know, and then so my five guitar heroes of mine, which there's only two I can still have a chance to run into, which was the first one was Ace, then Eddie, then Randy, then George Lynch, then Dime. Mm-hmm. So the only two I have a chance to see now is George and Ace.
Man.
Randy, you know, I can't see the other three.
Mm-hmm. Mike is saying, I started playing guitar at 12. It was Eddie Van Halen or Randy Rhoads. I went with Randy Rhoads, even though he was a master what he did, but I just thought Randy was more expressive with his playing. Very cool, man. Let's see.
Again, that's that classical influence.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's see. Boomster is saying both guys are necessary. I think he's talking about Edward and Randy.
Yep. Well, I mean, think about
subscribing.
It.
DBM.
Look how both of them changed metal music. They both did.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, yeah. And were they necessary? Yeah.
They were both very unique at what they did, even though people compare them and say, who's better? I mean, there is no better. There's different.
Mm-hmm.
And look what they both did. I mean, you guys know who they are, right? Yep.
That's why we're here talking about them.
And neither of them were born being that person. That's mm-hmm. what a lot of people don't, they don't, a lot of times you don't really understand or you don't think about is when somebody, you're like, Eddie Van Halen, he was born with the name Eddie Van Halen, but he wasn't the Eddie Van Halen that we all know. Yep. Same with Randy.
Mm-hmm.
Same thing, you know. Let's see, Uncle Raymond. Let's see, he's talking to ET5150. Raymond saying his niece Amanda was at Randy's gravesite. Oh, cool.
Yeah, on the anniversary of his death.
Man. Let's see. Sound the sirens. Hey, dudes. What a nice surprise for a great show this evening. Dude, thank you so much, man.
Thank you.
Thank you, man. 40 Grit is saying I'm both. I think he's probably talking about Edward and,
yeah,
and Randy.
Eddie
probably.
And Randy. Yep.
Let's see. 57 Carpenter used to live in San Francisco, Johnny Boone. That's a joke. Yes, I'm in Santa Cruz now. But. Let's see. Ricky Spanish is here. Good to see you guys. Let's see. Dean is here. We got a lot of people here, man. You guys, again, if you're brand new here, consider subscribing to the channel. We will do more of these episodes. And I'll admit it, you know, I do. We already do a weekly Van Halen show, so we're very heavy on the Halen. There you go. So if you like Van Halen, if you like Van Halen, you want to be here anyway. But I want to talk about all sorts of musicians and music. And you guys won't believe this. And I'm not going to embarrass you by saying this, but I'm going to say it. And the thing is, I'm the same. Okay. When I let Ron into the session here, when we were in the green room, you guys won't believe this. Well, maybe you will. He was listening to Frank Sinatra. Yeah. And he turned up the volume. He's like, Johnny, listen to this. This is one of the tracks off the album you have. And the thing is, I'm a huge Sinatra fan myself. I love the Rat Pack. I love all that stuff. I was just watching Carol Burnett reruns on Twitch last night. Sammy Davis Jr. was one of the hosts. It was hilarious, man. So, you know, we could do a show talking about any of that stuff too.
Yeah, I mean, the Rat Pack.
Music is music, you guys, and that's
right.
That's how it is. So let's see. Ed Dana is here. Good to see you, man. He says, What? Van Halen was a pop band? Is that true? Don't say that in my Van Halen group, man. They'll come after you like craziness. I've had to bring out the band hammer many times over there. Let's see. Shane is saying, I kick myself for not seeing Van Halen with Sammy. I was a diehard Dave Lee Roth era fan at the time. And passed on a few chances back then. Regret it now. Yeah, man. It's
well, you know, if I had it to do all over again, I would, every opportunity I'd take it. You know what I mean? I would just take, because you never know. You never know when it's going to end.
No, you don't. And the thing is, these days, you never know when you're going to end. You know, and well, we were in a show last night and I think we were talking, you know, afterwards and talking about, because you just had a birthday and.
Yep. And there's more years behind you than there are in front of you. You start thinking things a lot differently.
Right. Yeah. So, if you guys want to see, you know, a band live or
go do it,
whatever it is, just do it. Do it now, whatever that is. Especially smashing that subscribe and thumbs up button on the channel. Do that before you forget.
Yeah. Someone asked me what these numbers were. That's a decibel meter.
Wow, huh? Yeah. Oh, for volume?
Yeah. So I know when I'm blowing my eardrums out.
Mm-hmm. Dude, we could do a show on tinnitus, man.
I know. We have, kind of.
I know we have. I know. I was laying in bed, I think it was last night or the night before, and all of a sudden, this ear that rings nonstop anyway got louder all of a sudden, and I started thinking, oh, no, what if that doesn't stop? And luckily, it went back to the normal craziness
sound.
Anyway. Yeah, which I'm used to.
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's see. A couple more comments here, and then we'll get to we'll talk about the guitars. Yeah, Raymond, I saw Randy Rhoads May 19th, 1981, and photographed that show.
Raymond, I would love to see every one of those photographs.
Raymond, feel free to if you want to text any of those in. We have another background with the phone number on it, I think. Is it this one? Yeah. Yeah, we'll leave that up. Yeah, 415-952-3263. Feel free to text any of the photos that you took of Randy or Ozzy. We would love to see them. That would be...
I forgot I have this. That'd be awesome. I don't have the green screen up. So I don't know how well it's going to look.
If you don't have an actual green screen?
Yeah, well, yeah, I don't have it up, but I mean,
yeah,
I do have the
yeah, because yeah, when I do all the gaming stuff on Twitch, mm-hmm. I have the green curtain. See, it's already changing and everything. Yeah. Let's see, Ed Dana. I turn up the music because I'm hard of hearing. I'm hard of hearing because I turned up the
music. My hat's green.
Oh, there you go. Well, that's fine. That's cool. Let's see. Peggy, from what I see, Ozzy is not doing good. I did see a Facebook friend of mine did post like some recent photos of him. But met Ozzy on the Ultimate Sin Tour. Shane is
cool.
That's cool, man. Very cool. Okay. All right. So should I show the.
Yeah. Well, you want to go with the first one? The 1918 Army Navy guitar?
Sure. Here, let's do this. Let's open this. Here. By the way, you guys, let's see. Yes, we're doing a giveaway. Ron has a mug he wants to give away. So the way you win that is you participate in the chat. We'll be doing a random number thing a little later on. So that's how we do that. And by the way, if you are brand new here, we do a whole series of shows. This may be like a brand new series we're doing tonight, but tomorrow night we do a show called Talking Guitars, where you guessed it, we talk banjos. Just kidding. Saturday night we do a show called Strattery Night, where anything goes. We talk whatever, you know, and we usually have a crew of a few people. Sunday nights I do a show I call the Guitar ASMR Show, where I play the guitar, I do demos, I do product reviews. And then Mondays, I go live at Guitar Center, and I demonstrate whatever guitar, you know, we pick up or whatever. But and then Tuesday is the Van Halen show, where we talk all things Van Halen news, Van Halen history, trivia, all that stuff. So okay, is that how we... Okay. Let me just make sure this works correctly. Because it might not. Because like I said, if anything can go wrong, it will. And I think we kind of saw some of that earlier. Is that the right direction? Okay. Yeah, that works. Do you want me to show the paper that you typed up or not? Do we need to see that?
No, we don't need to see that. Just go through the photos.
We just want to see some guitars.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's the first one, the old acoustic. That Chuck.
Oh.
Chuck got that in there. It was 1918 Army Navy Gibson that Randy found. It was his grandfather's. And then his grandfather just went ahead and gifted it to him when Randy was 6 years old. So he played only acoustics from 6 to 12.
Oh, that's cool. Okay, let me open this back up because everything was like opposite. Yeah. So let's do that. Let's see. By the way, in the chat, you have any questions or comments? If you want to get Ron's attention, you can put at, and then what's your YouTube handle?
It's just Ron Gunner.
You can do at Ron Gunner, and for Ron, it'll appear orange. It should. If you're looking at the YouTube.
Yeah.
I don't know if in the StreamYard, I don't know if it'll do that. It might. It might not. Okay, let's see if I can. Okay, did you send all that stuff to Facebook?
Yeah, what's that? I mean, Messenger. Man, there's a lot of commercials playing.
Is there?
Yeah.
Well, thank you, Google. Okay. Yeah, because you sent me a lot of photos before that, too. So there's a lot of stuff to go through. Okay. All right. I do have a photo of an old acoustic, and then I... Okay. All right. Let's do that. We got this one right.
Yeah, should be from there down to everything for this show.
There we go.
Yep.
That one?
Yep.
That one right there? Okay, cool. Cool. So what's the history of
that? He just
guitar?
Found it in the closet. It was his grandfather's. And then his grandfather just ended up letting him have it when he was six. And then that's what he started to play on, just noodling around with stuff. And then they started noticing that he had a gift for it. So he started on that, started taking lessons. And he kind of played was learning like a Spanish flamenco type stuff. And mm-hmm. I think when he was 12, he wanted to go to electric, which is a guitar he got from his mom. And it was a Harmony Rocket, I think a 55 or 56. And it had the single cutaway.
I know those guitars. Yeah, the old shop I used to work at. We had tons of old Harmony Rocket guitars. Yeah.
The next picture should be Mrs. Rhoads holding that actual guitar.
Okay. So is this the actual guitar that he started on?
I don't know if that's the actual one. That's one just like it.
It's just
so,
like it.
So, yeah.
Do you know what the brand is?
It was a Army Navy from a Gibson version.
Because it's got interesting sound holes there.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like little bat wings or something. That's pretty cool. Okay.
So then you'll get into the next one, which was the Harmony.
Let's see, do we go this way?
Yep.
There we go.
That's it. For those who don't know, that's Randy's mom.
Mm-hmm.
And that's the first electric he played. And then he wanted to take electric guitar lessons. So she hooked him up with a teacher that they had there at the school. And after 9 months, the teacher came to Mrs. Rhoads and said, I can't teach Randy anymore. And, you know, she thought something was wrong. And she wanted to know why. He's like, well, for the past 2 or 3 months, he's been teaching me. And I've showed him everything I can. And he's learned it and surpassed me. So that was the end of that. And then he's starting at the school himself. I think he had like 60, 65 students. varied between 55 and 65. But he was known to have the most students at that time in the Burbank area. Now, sadly, that guitar was stolen a few years ago when they broke in and stole his white Marshall head, that guitar. It stole a bunch of stuff, a bunch of photos. I'm going to say probably a lot of that stuff that's behind her in that picture. And then they ended up finding a lot of it in a dumpster outside of L.A. And then Ozzy put out a $25,000 reward for the return of that guitar and the Marshall amp head. So I don't know if I heard at one point the amp head, they got it back. Then I heard, no, they didn't. So that I don't know for sure.
I wonder if the people that broke in knew what the stuff was.
I don't know.
Probably not. Well, who knows?
If they took the pictures and stuff, they ought to know, or they should have known. But yeah, that actual guitar, I don't think that was ever returned yet.
Man, that's too bad. All right.
So so now all of Randy's stuff is basically in a vault somewhere. And Kelly and Kathy won't disclose the location. If you look at that, that is an Ovation Tornado. That was a guitar he got, I think, in 72 and played it for about a year, I believe. Maybe two. I know when Quiet Riot was, he did play it a little bit in Quiet Riot. I do know that. But there, I think he's like maybe 15, somewhere in that area. And he liked that guitar. From what I've heard, he really did like that guitar, but he wanted something that just there was a reason why, and there's different people will tell you different reasons. One said he didn't like the guitar. One reason is he liked it, but it didn't look rock enough at that time. So you know, for whatever reason, you know, he ended up getting rid or not getting rid of it, but he ended up getting the next one, which is an SG.
That's kind of the same with this guitar right here. That's kind of the same thing with Van Halen. Is Edward played a 335.
Okay.
Originally. That's where the original pickup came from. That was in the Frankenstein guitar.
Oh, okay.
It was from a 335. And when Eddie would play a guitar shaped like that, the band would say, hey, either get some dark sunglasses because you look like Roy Orbison, or get rid of the guitar. And that's what he had to do. Yeah. So, but hey, that's similar. They both played 335 style hollow body guitars. That's a similar thing. All right.
So the next one would be that. Which when he originally got it was red, and
is that Randy?
Yeah, that's Randy.
That's him.
Like,
wow.
15 years old, 15, 16 maybe. But it was originally red, and like Edward, he painted it. He painted it black. The issue he liked how it played, but the issue he complained about with that guitar is it never stayed in tune. It just he had a hard time keeping it in tune. But he did use that in some of the recording sessions with Quiet Riot. Because Quiet Riot did do two releases in Japan, which are getting harder and harder to get here in the United States. But, so that guitar was used on that, and he also used a Strat. I think it was like a natural. Well, I think it was like a brown Strat. I don't know what year. There's not a lot of information on that, on the Strat. There's just a few pictures of him playing it in the studio. But yeah, he liked the way that guitar sounded. He liked how it felt. He liked how it sounded. He just, it wouldn't stay in tune.
Yeah, I can see those guitars not staying in tune, especially if you play like somebody like Randy played.
Plus, you know, he always did where he would put his hand on the body and the hand behind the headstock and bend the neck to get a little sound. And I think that had with the SG, it didn't take it as well as the Les Paul, Les Paul did.
Yeah. Cool. All right.
So there we get into that. That is a 74 Les Paul that was a early birthday present given to him by Quiet Riot's first manager, Dennis. And even though he gave it to Randy for his birthday, Randy insisted on paying for the guitar and paid him back for it. And that guitar was initially white and obviously it's now yellowed. That turned out to be one of his favorite touring and performing guitars. And their drummer, Drew, said that was probably the best thing that ever happened to Randy was getting that guitar. For a long time, he thought it was a 63. And then when he was in England recording, he found out it was actually a 74. So that's 1975 and 76 right there.
Oh, cool. I've always liked those, the white of, I guess it's a custom?
The gold.
Right, yeah, Les Paul custom?
Yep.
Yeah, I have an Epiphone version of that, which I've had years and years and years. And for me, it was a backup guitar to my regular, whatever I played at the time. It was like a backup touring guitar for me.
Okay.
That particular.
Style. He ended up loving that. Excuse me. He ended up loving how that thing played, and it stayed in tune a lot better than the SG did. So. There's another one, the SG.
So that's Randy.
Yeah, that's Randy. That's Kevin DeBro. See, yeah, that's Quiet Riot. That's
I don't. You know, me being the Van Halen dude, I can look at photos of Van Halen from, you know, the early 70s and, oh yeah, you know, but I would, like, if I saw that, this photo out of nowhere, I would never have thought that was Quiet Riot.
Well, that's why when Ozzy first saw him, I thought he was a chick. And it's Kelly Garney, the original bass player, who him and Randy went to school together. And Randy actually showed him how to play bass. So they played for a long time.
That's a cool Rickenbacker bass there too.
That's Kevin in the middle. But they all look like they need to eat a sandwich or two.
Oh gosh. Okay. What year was this? What year was that photo?
That was 75.
Oh, okay, cool.
That's when Randy called Kevin to come try out for the band. It was 1970, early 75.
Early 75. Man. So it's almost like he like him and Edward were like doing the same thing at the same time.
Yeah.
Starting band. Well, what year was Randy born?
He's 56. Eddie was a year older.
There you go.
Yeah.
So I can, that there is a lot of similarities.
Yeah, there is.
Really? Okay, cool. This is cool, man. See, I'm learning. See? I'm learning stuff too.
Then there's also rumors that he painted that SG white, but I don't know. Because there's a picture of him. I only know of one picture of him holding a white SG. And they're like, well, is that one he did? Did he do that? And there we go. That is a young Carl Sandoval.
You
want to say it. That, of course, is the guitar he's most, Randy and Carl are both most associated with. That's got a Dan Electro neck on it, by the way, on that guitar.
Oh, really?
Yep. Like a 1959, something like that.
Dan Electro neck, but they must have added to the headstock.
Yeah, he did. And the funny thing is, right after Randy got it, he broke that headstock too. He knocked it over and broke. Carl figured it out. But the whole reason that came about is now we're going to bring in George Lynch. Randy was watching George Lynch play at one of the clubs and went backstage after the show. And George Lynch had a V. It kind of had like a V headstock on it, too. And Randy asked to play it, so George let him play it. And the story goes, Randy fell in love with it instantly and asked George, where did you get it? And he said, oh, this guy named Carl Sandoval built it for me. He used to work for Charvel. And at the time when Randy did contract him for this, he had left Charvel by that time. Mm-hmm. And was doing his own, starting his own thing, which was just like a double car garage, I believe, at that time, with one or two little workbenches and started. But he went there and they drew it up. They decided what to do with it. And you can go on YouTube and look at videos of Carl telling a story that there was an old, very old acoustic in his house. Or apartment, whatever, condo, whatever it was, they were at the time when mm-hmm. they were, you know, writing out what they wanted to do to this guitar and how they wanted to make it and what Randy wanted and everything. He said, and Randy played, he said the action was, you know, really high and everything. He said, but that guitar never sounded as good ever as it did that when Randy was sitting there at his kitchen table playing that thing. I was just amazed at how good he could play. And what he was able to do with the guitar that had, you know, 3/4 inch gap between the string and the fretboard.
Mm-hmm.
So
interesting.
That guitar ended up being a combination of like Fender Gibson. It's got the inline six, like Fender tuners. It had the original one had the Fender tremolo on it. You had two humbuckers. And if you look if you look, of course that's before they're installed, but you look, you see the four pots set up just like the Les Paul. And the switch, though, ended up being towards the back of the top wing. Probably right where you see Carl's arm going past the body, right in that area. Well, if you look really close, third dot from the bottom, right. Right,
I'm assuming
next.
These are the volume and tones right here.
Yeah, it was set up pretty much just like a Les Paul. So you had volume, tone.
So where's the switch?
Okay, go over to the top. No, other end. Clear down on the top wing, down in the corner. All the way down. Right there.
Down here?
Yeah, okay. Now
right there?
Come over three dots. three. Okay, now look right above it. You'll see a little discoloration. That's the hole for the switch.
Here.
Right. Yep, right there.
Oh, no kidding.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. See, I didn't know that. Nice shorts.
Well, yeah. It was 78, 79. So.
Degrees?
Who knows?
He's still around, right?
Yep, Carl's still around, still making us.
Well, that's funny because I was just at the NAMM show and I think I saw him there.
Probably.
And I think he was holding a polka dot guitar. No joke.
Now he puts like it's got a silver plaque thing kind of on the headstock.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so it was a 25 and a half scale length. But you know, it was kind of a combination of what Randy liked into it. Then the whole polka dot thing was his whole through Quiet Riot. You know, he wore polka dot bow ties.
The bow tie vest. Yeah.
Yeah. So that's why he went with the polka dot on that.
Oh, cool, man. Cool. All right. Let's see. Next.
Okay. Now we get into 1980. When he went to the Charvel factory there in San Dimas, mm-hmm. and he talked to Grover, and on his way back from London, working, like he was living with Ozzy and Ozzy's first wife at the time, so they could work on the records. But he came back and he talked to Grover Jackson, and he handed Grover this, basically it was a napkin that Randy had sketched this body type out, and what it came from was he was flying on the Concorde. I don't know. Some people who are younger might even know, not even know what the Concorde was, but it was a really weird looking.
Yeah,
plane.
Like I have no idea what that is.
Yeah, okay, well, it was shaped like that guitar.
I'm just kidding. Yeah.
And so
I know what the Concorde is because they had one in Superman 2.
That's right. They did.
The Concorde. But I think they cut that part out. It was only on the ABC TV part of the movie.
He had flown on that, and he wanted to build a guitar based on that body shape because the one complaint that he had about the polka dot was everybody said it was a Gibson V, which it wasn't, you know, because it was basically the same shape. So he wanted something a little different. So he sketched that, and they did it. And
let me say one thing.
Okay.
I just heard mega thunder going on out there. So if I vanish, that means my power has just cut out. So if that happens,
Johnny
just keep going.
Away. Okay.
Just keep going. The thing is, though, if that happens, like the photo will go away, I'll go away, and it'll just be you on the screen.
Okay.
So if that happens, just keep going, keep talking.
All right.
And then I'll jump on my phone.
Okay.
Like podcast style. Yeah, I'm getting worried now, man. That was loud. You guys probably heard that, actually.
Yeah, so he got back with Grover, and they decided to do it. And there was even a story where when they were making cuts on it, Randy couldn't stand to be there and watch him cut on it, cut the body. But what had happened is they built a guitar to Randy's specs. And then Grover in late 78 had bought Charvel guitars from Wayne Charvel, and he just got the company back up and going. But because that was such a drastic shape, Grover didn't want to put the Charvel name on it. So it was Randy's suggestion to put the Jackson name on it. Grover Jackson, you build it, call it a Jackson. So Randy is technically the founder of Jackson Guitars.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
Which would explain why I own a crap load of them.
So Randy is your number one.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what it seems like. Because you know all this and
yep. Well, I mean, like cool. I said, you know, 5 years after his death, he got my wife and I together and his mom was crying about when I talked to Mrs. Rhoads a couple times before she died.
Uh-huh.
So, yeah, I mean, there's a big, big connection there. And I told that story once before on the show. It's too long to tell it now. So, but, yeah,
well,
Randy,
if I vanish, you can tell it.
Well, there we go. But, yeah, you know, 5 years after he died, he because of him, my wife and I got together. And that's why our son, well, I wanted to name him Randy to begin with. But that was his middle name ended up being Randy. And if anybody's watched the show before, Cole is the lead guitarist for the band Faith in Failure. And Randy, he's got two idols, Randy and Sinister Gates. So
cool. And we interviewed them, or I interviewed them, your son's band. They were on here.
That was in January, yeah.
So if you guys want to see that, check out the... who is this? Who is that? If you want to see that video, check out the interviews section on the YouTube channel here, and you'll see that from a few months ago.
January 24th.
Wow. January 24th. All right. So next photo. Here we go.
Well, yeah. Now, if you look at where the body line on the bottom comes up to the frets, it's like the 15th fret.
Down here?
Yeah. See where it meets at the end of it? Clear up there?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that obviously, when you got to the higher register, it wasn't that easy to play. And Randy, being a smaller statue guy, he was able to do it, but he said it was just we need to change it. So that's where they came in with the black Jackson. Black and gold,
mm-hmm.
which there should be pictures of that.
I think those are the ones that were on the poster. I told you I used to have a poster on my wall when I was when I first started playing the guitar.
Oh, okay.
I had a poster. It was Randy holding a guitar and looking down, and then there were other guitars like sitting next to him. And I think it's probably a famous photo. I think one of the guitars was the black and gold.
The black, yeah.
And then one was probably the logo, this one, or he's probably playing this one.
If you look at the logo, that's like Grover's hand print painted Jackson on the logo.
Oh, up here?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. That's cool. Okay.
So there, yeah, that was the second one. Now, if you notice, the body and neck is much lower on it.
Mm-hmm.
No tremolo on that one. It was black and gold. And that's got the first shark fin inlays on it, too. So Randy did get to play this on tour. I don't know if he recorded Diary of a Madman using this one or not, but I do know he played it on stage. And he really liked it. And then there were just a few other changes. You know, the more he played it, he was like, well, can we do this? Can we do this? So that ended up being the third one, which I heard. I don't know how true it is. You would have to ask Mr. Jackson himself. But I heard that it was completed the day they found out Randy died. The third and fourth one.
Hmm.
And the third one was white also. And it got mistakenly sold at the NAMM show. Charvel Jackson had
Later on?
Yeah. It was after, obviously after Randy died. It was like 83, 84 maybe. They had taken it to the NAMM show and they had their display. And Grover, from what I was told, Grover had left the booth for whatever reason. Who knows? You know, go to the bathroom, get something to eat, or go talk, whatever. And whoever was working there sold that third one, the third Jackson ever made.
Oh, man.
Damn. And then there was a fourth one, which was gold, because Randy had written down changes he wanted on them. So there was a fourth one that was gold, and Vinnie Vincent ended up with that one. Which there's pictures of him playing it live too.
I think so, I've seen him playing that one. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's cool.
So in my opinion, I mean, even though Randy never got to play it or the other white one, he only played one and two. He didn't get to play three and four. But in my opinion, again, it's just my opinion. We all have them. I think both of those should have went to the Rhoads family. Well, obviously the white one got sold, so that couldn't help it. But the gold one, that could have went to Mrs. Rhoads.
So the white one that got sold at the NAMM show
was just put up for auction a year or two ago.
Oh, okay. I was going to ask if anybody knew where that one was. Kind of like the Paul McCartney bass,
Yeah, yeah. The guy had bought it and sold it to the second guy, and that's the guy that had it for 30 some years. And then just last year or maybe 2 years ago, it went up for auction. I don't remember what it sold for, but it was the missing third Jackson guitar.
Wow.
So you're looking at the second Jackson guitar ever made right there.
The black and gold.
Yeah. So it was white and black, or white with the white with the black pinstripes, the black and gold. Then the third one was also white, but I think it had, it might have had a reverse headstock and upside down inlays.
Mm-hmm.
And then the gold one is the one Vinnie Vincent had. And there are pictures of Vinnie playing it. Oh, and for those of you...
I've seen those, yeah.
For those of you who are interested in knowing, the polka dot guitar, when Randy bought that, he paid $740 for it.
Wow.
Now I don't think you could buy the wood to make that guitar for that price.
Probably not. Black and gold.
Is
that the actual one?
That's the actual one right there. They had Jackson, or now Fender, they did reissues of them, and they had the Rhoads family. They got
years ago.
Yeah.
Years.
Yeah.
I know the guy that was involved in that. Yeah.
Okay. And they were doing the measurements and everything to make them exactly the same.
Mm-hmm.
And then they sold
that
for $12,600.56.
Yeah.
Which was his birthday.
Oh, that's cool. Nice.
So, yeah, that's the one you just saw in the picture with Randy.
Yeah.
You can see how the gold is now tarnished and everything.
Mm-hmm. That's wild, man. Okay, let's see.
Yeah, that's the first one, the Concord.
That's the Concord right there.
Yeah.
Let's see. Comments. Let's check out the comments. 40 Grit saying, I think Mike Shannon was there. Yeah. Roscoe. Hey, welcome. We got some new names. Yeah, if you're brand new here, consider subscribing to the channel. We talk a lot of guitar stuff. We have a great time all the time. I think you guys know what that quote is from. Chris King is here.
Chris
King, there you are. We couldn't see your avatar earlier. But now we can. What is that? Okay. 40 Grit is saying the Rhoads family have the important ones. That's cool. Here's the third prototype. Oh, wow. Is that one of the ones you were talking about?
Yeah, that's the one that was sold at the NAMM show.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah, I remember watching an interview with Grover, and he's like, he was livid, mad, and then sick over that, because it wasn't supposed to be sold.
Oh, obviously.
But the guy working the counter didn't know, and he just said, okay, I'll sell it.
At the NAMM? Well, the thing is at the NAMM, well, even these days, because I go to the NAMM show all the time, and when if they do sell a guitar there,
mm-hmm.
like if they do sell something, it's not like they give them money and they just take the guitar and they walk out. Maybe that something, I don't know.
Either 83 or 84, probably 83.
Mm-hmm. Hmm. Yeah, that's too bad, man. Okay, so which tour was this?
That's Diary of Madman, because you could see the castle background on it. Now, here's an interesting thing: when the show started, when the curtains went up, or went away, mm-hmm. the smoke and stuff, and Ozzy came out down the staircase. Randy, and then initially Bob Daisley, and then it ended up being Rudy. They were that like doorway there behind where Randy's behind him. They stood mm-hmm. there, and it was like an iron gate.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Sharon suggested to Randy that he put black duct tape on the back of that guitar, because he'd hold the guitar upside down why the gate was coming up, so she didn't want the white being shown right away. So when they got the original one, when they got that in their hand to make the replicas, they even put the black duct tape on the back of them, just like the original.
That's cool.
It was just to black it out, so so there was no.
Yeah, I can see that. Boomster, Johnny, you should play your. What interview is that? Which one?
Minari interview from NAMM.
I'm not sure what that is. I'm not sure. Janice, can you send me a tweet on X if you understand that? Tag Ron in the tweet too. By the way, that reminds me. You guys share these videos out. If you guys are on X, I didn't even show most of the. Yeah, most of the stuff we normally do, we didn't even do. Let's just do that stuff now. You guys, we're live on Facebook. Johnny Bean Facebook page. You can help support the channel using Facebook stars. And normally on the Van Halen shows, we're live in the Van Halen group. I've got a Van Halen group on Facebook, the second largest at over 63,000 members. I also have an EVH Gear fans live group. Huge. I'm a huge fan of the EVH Gear stuff. And then I've got the Johnny Bean TV page as well. We're live on Twitch right now. And this episode will be a podcast on Spotify afterwards. We're also on X. You can find me over there. Ron is over there. Ron, what's your Twitter handle?
Ron Gunner, I think. I don't know. I don't remember.
I think it's yeah. Ron underscore Gunner, and it has a name after it, or a number after it, I think.
Oh, 065?
I don't know.
I don't know.
That's why I can't tag Laz in anything on Twitter, because his name, it isn't even anything. But anyway, you guys, I'm Johnny Bean everywhere there is, so you can find me everywhere, every platform there is. So there you go. And hey, you want to get some cool gear, Sweetwater affiliate links down below. So there you go. And by the way, we do a show Fridays, so tomorrow night, come on back, Talking Guitars, 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific, right here on Johnny Bean YouTube, Twitch, and Facebook pages.
It's a good time.
It's a most excellent time. It really is. Let's see. Okay. All right.
So now we get into the Black Les Paul.
Keep going. Oh, cool. Yeah. Okay. I do this with a MacBook, which doesn't like me. So we have to be very careful that it doesn't freeze.
Oh, well, there's another picture of the black.
There you go.
Second Jackson.
So you got the black guitar right there. There's two other ones. Are those the actual ones?
Yeah, those are the actual ones when they were taken to be figured out so they could make the replicas.
Replicated.
Mm-hmm.
That's cool. That's cool, man. Do you have any of those?
No. I wish I did.
Not yet.
No. Yeah, not yet. I might.
You might.
Okay, now there you go. That's the black. That's a 57 Les Paul that he got. I'm going to say November, sometime in November or very early December of 81.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's just, I don't know if he played it live. I have no idea. I've never seen a picture of him playing out on stage ever.
Okay.
I've just seen like a couple posters with him holding it. And then, you know, obviously in March, 3 months later, he was gone. So, And I don't even know. I mean, I'm sure the Rhoads family has that guitar too, but other than the posters, I've never seen that. You know, I'm not saying that he didn't play it live. I've never seen any photos of it.
And he's your number one too.
Yeah.
So if you've never seen a photo of him playing that, probably not.
But that
unless it does happen. And by the way, Neil, great to see you, man. Neil.
But if you notice, it's got three humbuckers in it. That's how it was when he bought it.
Huh.
And it is a 1957. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. 40 Grit saying that's a Frampton. Peter Frampton guitar. And also you're looking for one of those. Cool.
So I'm sure I'm sure Mrs. Rhoads and now Kelly and Kathy have that too.
Oh yeah, definitely. Yeah, Neil, great to see you, man. Neil, you got to jump on one of these shows sometime, man. Been long time internet friends with Neil there. Okay, next one.
I think there's just one more picture of Randy with that guitar.
Okay. Well, I can see what's coming up if you look at the bottom of the screen. Yeah. After this, we go, and it's just those lists that you made for me.
Oh, okay.
So should we show those?
Nah, you don't have to.
We'll save those for later.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, cool. Okay, let's see. Very interesting. Yeah, I'm sure I saw him at the NAMM show just last January.
Yeah, he was there. Like, I know he was there.
Like,
yeah.
I literally saw him, and he was holding a polka dot guitar when I saw him. Exactly like this, but years later, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I think our friend Laz, the guy that was driving earlier, I think he actually talked to him. I didn't talk to him. I should have. But.
Well, if you see him next year. Well, hopefully I'm there with you next year.
Dude.
And for those of you who are new here and don't know, right here above my head is one of those polka dots. But I leave it there. I don't touch it.
Mm.
Because last time I took it down and I put it up, I bumped it and chipped the clear coat.
Oh, no.
So it stays right there.
Oh, dude.
But I also have a lot of Jacksons.
Yeah, look at that.
And that's just, I mean, I got a lot in storage. That's just what's here. But, Johnny, I'm going to send you two more pictures.
Okay.
And I found something that I'm going to have to order from Grover Jackson.
Cool. Let's see. We got comments here. Neil says, nice collection, Ron.
Thank you.
There you go. Uncle Raymond is saying he thinks that Amanda talked to him. She probably did, because the booth that she was at was just right around the corner from where he, from where I saw him. Mike says, okay, so that's 1982, I guess. Let's see. Roscoe is saying Carl is a cool dude. I should have talked to him. I didn't. I saw him.
You should have.
I saw him. I didn't. I knew who he was, too. But for some reason, I was busy. I forget. Next time, though. Dude, yeah, Ron. Okay. You got to come to the NAMM show next year, man. You definitely got to be there.
Remember, I was telling you Sims Custom Guitar Paint.
Mm-hmm.
Did a couple for Grover. I just sent you.
That's what
one
this is.
Them.
That's what this is.
Yep, I got to get one of those. Look at that single pickup.
What is that? What guitar is
it's,
that?
It's a Grover Jackson. There's a picture of the headstock. So, but you notice it's paint. It's the Strat style polka dot. It's got the bow tie inlays, but not every one.
Look at that.
Then there's a picture of the headstock.
That's cool. And then it would have like a Floyd, I guess.
Floyd Rose. Yep.
Oh, there we can see that. Yeah.
That was painted by Sims Custom in Tennessee.
Sims.
Look. Made in USA by Grover Jackson.
Whoa.
I'm going to have to order one of those.
That's cool, man. Wow. Strat style Ian is saying. Dude, right on.
I don't know what the prices are. I will track Grover down and I'll find out.
If you come to the NAMM show, you might see him. I've seen him there many times. I've talked to him. Yeah. Yeah, he's there.
But when I saw that, it was posted for 11 minutes when I saw the short on that. It was only on for 11 minutes, and I was like, "Uh-oh, I got it." I took the pictures, and I have to track Grover down and find out how much those are and order one.
Oh wow! Let's see. 40 Grit is saying the OG guitars are awesome. I have a prototype, dude. No way.
Cool.
Right on. There we go. By the way, if there's somebody named Nightbot in the chat, that is me. Although Nightbot is getting a little out of control. Little spammy, but anything Nightbot posts in the chat, those are links actually to previous videos on the channel here or ways to help support the channel or whatever. So you can trust anything Nightbot is saying. Just saying, I used to work at a record shop, in like 1989, 1990.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember that on display on the wall. Well, maybe not that exact one, because that might that might be a newer one, but yeah. I remember there was those back then.
This will be hanging on the wall in the studio.
Nice.
I got a question, a trivia question for the chat.
Cool.
Does anybody know what Randy's nickname was?
No Googling.
Yeah.
You have a to real, answer within like 10 seconds.
Yeah, a real fan would know.
Let's see.
Oh, okay. Chuck got it.
Snoopy?
Yep.
Snoopy? Wow, cool. 40 Grit saying you should do a poll, Blizzard versus Diary. Should we do that?
Yeah.
Should we do that? Okay, let's how do we do that? It's been a while. Sort of poll. Okay.
But yeah, like I said, you know, Ace Frehley got me to get interested in guitar. Then when I heard Eruption, that was like, wow. Then when I heard Randy, I was like, whoa.
So, and then you start playing and you're like, whoa. Man.
You know, prior to Ace Frehley, it's Frehley, but a lot of people say Frehley. I was playing Beatles and CCR because I've started playing at 5 years old, which means I've been playing now for 54 years.
Dude.
Probably times I change a string. But the first guitar is playing on is sitting right back there. That Les Paul Jr.
That's pretty cool, man. Okay, so poll in the chat. Are those the only two? Was Randy only on two albums?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I don't know that.
He was on two for Quiet Riot, which, you know, wasn't really sold over here, and then two for Ozzy.
Do you have those?
No. I have a friend that lives in Japan, and he's trying to find them for me. I told him, I said, you find them, buy them, and let me know what they cost. I'll PayPal you the money.
Have you ever heard them?
No, just parts of them.
Like a lot of that stuff you can probably find on YouTube, you know. But
I did hear, and I don't know if it's true, it's just what I heard, that Randy didn't really care for those because they were young, didn't know what they were doing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and so it wasn't his best. And that's another thing with the Diary of Madman album. It was recorded, you know, right after the Blizzard tour in like a very short time. And I do remember seeing an article where Randy was interviewed. It's probably one of my old guitar magazines with him on the cover. That album got released while they were back out on the road. Each song has a solo, but most of them were just filler solos to take up the space where it's supposed to be until he could figure something out. You know, really what he wanted to do. And it was released that way. The only one he had obviously the song Diary of Madman, which, I mean, what did you think of that? You listened to it yesterday.
Mm-hmm. I thought it was good. Yeah, I'd never heard, I'll admit, I'd never heard it before.
Oh, really?
No.
Oh, wow.
No, I had never heard that.
Well, see, I never listened to Van Halen 3 before until a couple weeks ago.
We just had the anniversary.
Yeah.
Okay. See, I'll admit this, you guys. I mean, those of you guys that know me, and anybody that I'm sure we have a lot of new people here tonight. I'm like a Van Halen dude. Like, I've got all this Van Halen stuff behind me, and Andy Summers, you know, the Police. That's like a couple of my heroes, you know. So you guys can ask me anything about that stuff, and I can tell you, Randy Rhoads.
The Police.
Yeah, there you go. Randy Rhoads, I really don't know. So I'm learning some stuff too. But no, I had never heard that song before ever. But
because people's asked me, well, you know, if they've never heard Randy before, what's the first song you'd recommend for them to hear? And mm-hmm. a lot of people say Crazy Train. But I think the
classical, I've heard that billions of times, that one. Yeah.
But I think the classical influence on him comes out big time in Diary of Madman, which Bob Daisley.
That whole intro was that.
Yeah. And Bob's the one that wrote most of the words for both those albums.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so it was interesting. Because that made me buy a Ramirez classical guitar back in the 80s. And that's all. Here's another question for the chat. Chuck, see if you know this one. When Randy got his first royalty check from one of the Ozzy albums, what was the first thing he bought? They're probably Googling it.
Pizza?
No. Yep, Chuck got it. He spent $5,000 on a classical guitar in 1980 or 81.
Wow.
Neil, that's what he drove, a VW Scirocco, and Kathy is having it restored to just how it was. His sister Kathy's having it restored to just how it was when Randy drove it last.
That's cool.
And also, for those of you who don't know, his sister Kathy and her husband have a Randy Rhoads wine, which I do not have a bottle of it yet, but I want one. Hey, you guys are in California. You can get one. I'll pay for it and send it.
We are. Why? Are they based out here?
Yeah.
That's out here?
Yeah. Randy Rhoads wine.
Where is it at?
Where's the
vineyard? Where's the vineyard located?
I don't know. I'd have to look it up.
Because most of that stuff is up here in Northern California. A lot of
the Napa Valley stuff.
Okay. Neil's saying it's in Burbank. Okay. Well, next time we're down there, we'll have to look into that.
Yeah. If you can grab a bottle for me, let me know. I'll PayPal you guys the money. Ian's Guitar Shack. I used to have a Ramirez classical that I paid $4,000 for in the 80s, and I sold it in the early 90s. But I made money off of it, so I sold it for more than I paid for.
That's good.
But you want to talk about a classical? I mean, if you grabbed a pick and strummed a chord on it, the thing just like wanted to vibrate off your lap. I mean, it was. I sold it because that guitar needed a better classical guitar player than I was.
Hmm.
It was built for someone who can really play classical guitar, and that's who I sold it to. So, and the whole reason I bought it was because of Randy.
There you go.
Yeah, you're right, Randy. She sent me a photo of her and Kathy together. The bottles have the polka dot V on the bottles. I just want a bottle. I don't drink. I never did. I'm not going to open it. I just want it to put on the wall.
I'm sure we can get one of those. By the way, we got the poll here. Which album is better, Blizzard or Diary? Everybody's saying Diary. Is that a fair?
Well, because that's where Randy got to showcase the talent a little bit more. It's just a shame that he didn't get to put the solos in that he really wanted. And I mean, some of the, like Diary and SATO. Well, let me see.
So wait. So are the solos that are on there, are those from like the demos?
Well, it's when they were recording them, but when it come time for the part for the solo, he just did a fill because he always did a lot of the triple tracking. But he never played it exactly the same. But they would mix, and what Max would do is he would take the best one, and that would be the middle, the main solo. Uh-huh. Then he would put the other, so it created like a chorus effect with it. So, like Believer, Diary Madman, SATO.
Neil, that
and Over the Mountain. I think those are the only ones that actually have the what he wanted on the solo. The other ones were just stuff he put in to fill the spot until he came up with something better, and then he never had a chance to do it.
Neil is saying there's one in Santa Rosa, meaning a vineyard that that carries that.
Oh, cool! How far?
Santa
away
Rosa
is
not far from me. No.
Okay.
That's not far. So wait a minute. Let me ask this. And whatever happened to Laz? He drove away. Because see, I don't know any of this stuff.
Okay.
I would say I'm a casual fan. Okay.
Okay.
And of course, Crazy Train. I mean, I've heard that a million times. Yeah. And I when I hear it, I can tell that the guitars were double tracked. The solos were double tracked because you can hear it. It's either it has a heavy chorus on it, or it's twice, three times.
He triple tracked them. Yeah.
So you can hear that.
He didn't play it identical all three times. There's just a little slight difference in the whole.
That's
of
why
another.
They're off. Yeah. That's why you hear that. It's probably an effect. It was probably an effect that they were using. So let's take that album, the one you're saying where he played the solos, where he just did fill solos.
Yep.
Okay. And then, so what was the deal? So he did that, and then they ended up releasing it.
They released it while they were back on tour.
So it came out. They released it, and he heard it, and it sounds like he probably wasn't happy
yeah,
about
he,
it.
Yeah, he wasn't.
Yeah, look at that.
Now, what sucks is I don't know which side I want to display.
Probably that
one. I might have to go buy another one so I can hang them both up.
Yeah. Well, that's the classic. That's like the classic shot right there of like the cover. And I'm guessing the other side was like the back of the
album. Yeah. Yeah. Now, the one thing about this that isn't right is this picture. That is not who's on the album other than Randy and Ozzy.
Mm-hmm.
Rudy was not on the album, and neither was Tommy. It was Lee Kersick. And then Bob Daisley.
But those guys were in the touring band.
This was the touring band, yes.
Right.
But if you just look at the album, it's like it's saying it was they were on, you know, more or less leads you to believe that they were the ones who recorded this, which isn't correct.
Mm-hmm.
So, but I've been a fan of Ozzy since Black Sabbath. So.
Oh, okay. Neil is saying Kathy's family's winery is in Santa Rosa, which is not far from me.
Cool. Okay.
I believe they got married when Randy was still alive, but they were based in Burbank. Okay.
Yeah, they did because Randy collected trains, little train sets.
Mm-hmm.
And I listened to a album or an interview with Kathy where the December before he died, I guess her husband made a platform to where he could set all the trains up for him. I don't know if it was a Christmas present or a birthday, because his birthday is December 6th. So.
Yeah, Lewis, it'd be interesting if Randy was still around, the music he would have done later.
Well, yeah, think what died within him. And that was the thing I always got when people was wanting to do the Eddie and Randy thing. Well, one of the comment was, well, look what all Eddie's done. I said, well, yeah, Eddie got to live a lot longer than Randy did too. You know, so, and there's a thing also where Randy supposedly told Ozzy that he was going to fulfill his contract, which would have been the third album, which ended up being Bark at the Moon with Jake.
Mm-hmm.
But He was going to fulfill the contract, need a third album and a tour, and then that was it. He wanted to go back to school to get his master's in classical guitar. From what I hear, Ozzy wasn't happy about it, and then everybody says Randy was going to quit. Well, I watched an interview with Kathy not too long ago where she said that Randy didn't want to tour anymore. He still would have done albums, recording albums with Ozzy, just not tour. So again, but you know, everybody, you know, you hear something and then they turn into something else. So
look at this. Kurt Rocks just sent in a photo of these. I assume you've seen these.
Yeah. Yep. Yep.
There you go.
That's it.
That's cool. And according to this caption,
Neil.
Photography by Neil Zlozauer.
Hey, folks, Neil Zlozauer here. Check out my good friend, Johnny Bean TV.
Awesome. Thank you so much.
But let me do one more. Where is it?
We're good Facebook friends.
Wait, where is it, though? The Johnny Bean TV.
It's YouTube, Facebook, okay. Twitter. Whatever.
Okay, let's do one more.
And Twitch.
Hey, folks, Neil Zlozauer here. Check out Johnny Bean TV on Facebook and YouTube. You'll enjoy it.
There you go.
Yeah. Neil Zlozauer. Very cool. Very cool. Yeah. Other Neil. Yeah. Anytime somebody mentions a name and it's somebody that I've met or that I have a channel ID from, I play it. So it's kind of like, it's like we have a lot of fun around here, apparently. Yeah. Yeah, we have a good time.
We try to, anyhow.
We try. Well, yeah, we do. Do or do not.
There is no try.
There is no try. That's right.
So, again, we are giving away this mug.
Oh, yeah. Should we do that?
Yeah, go ahead.
We should probably do that. Okay, is there a significance in a number with Randy, with Randy Rhoads? Because, you know, with Van Halen, of course, you know, 5150, yeah. 1984, you know.
Unless you want to go with his birthday, 12,056, 12,500.
Is that too much? 12,000.
Because I mean, you know, March 19th, I really don't, that's the day he died, and it's.
Nah, I wouldn't. Yeah, I
don't
do
like to.
So wait, what's his birthday?
December 6th, 1956.
Six.
So it's 12.
That's a big number.
12556.
12.
Or 12656.
I put 1261956.
No.
What number? Just, is that 126,000?
Just do 12,656.
Okay.
Which is those guitars sold for, by the way.
12,656?
Yep.
Is that too much for a mug?
I don't know.
No, it's not. Okay. All right, you guys. The way this works is we do a random, well, it's not random, I mean we put a number in the giveaway tool, and then you guys have to guess the number between zero and that number. That's a big number, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
12,600.
That's
actually, it's not,
so
because
far.
didn't we do 10,000 before?
Yeah, and it took and, like
and
5
Patty
minutes.
And Patty got it.
Yeah.
I mean, Peggy?
Peggy got it in no time.
What happened to Patty? Okay. Peggy in the chat. It's Peggy in the chat. All right, let's do it. Boo. Okay. All right, the giveaway has started. Enter a number between 0 and 12,656. Michael's saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 8. I'll give you guys a hint right off the bat, okay? Should I?
Go ahead.
Okay. All right. It's four digits. Two of the numbers are the same. Right? And you know what it almost is? Like I just said, like, dude, we're going to give it away. Me and my stupid hints, I give this. We're giving
everything away.
Okay. You know how I said, you know, there's Van Halen, there's 5150?
Yep.
This is kind of like a 5150 in a number, sort of. Does that make sense? I don't know. I'm confused,
no,
too.
No, that does not, because I'm thinking.
There's four digits.
6160?
Could be. Somebody's going to get this. See? Somebody's going to get this. It's okay, though. It's okay, because you have to ship it. Okay. There's four digits. Two of the digits are the same. And the number, it's kind of like a 5150, sort of. If you think of it that way. Like, it could be considered like a 5150 type of number. It kind of rhymes with it, but not really. Does that make sense?
No.
I know it doesn't.
I'm lost on that one.
I'll give you one more hint. And there's only nine digits in between. There's two sets of numbers. There's only nine digits in between them. I probably just gave it away. I don't know. It's very confusing, but
yeah.
But not really. Somebody's gonna, either Peggy or Lewis are gonna get this. And that's okay. What?
Repeat it, Johnny.
Repeat what?
Your hint.
The number? There's four digits. Two of the numbers in the four digits are identical. But between the four digits, between the two sets of digits, there's only nine digits in between. Does that make sense?
That's a little bit better. Oh, now we got to add.
Yeah. And you have to be on YouTube to do this. You can't be on Facebook. Well, no way. Michael B. Live got it. Michael B., how did you get it? 4049 was the number. Two of the digits were the same. There's only nine digits in between the two sets of numbers. And I said it's kind of like a 5150, 4040, kind of, right? Michael got it. Michael got it, dude. But hey, when we start giving away cars and houses, we're not giving you guys hints at all.
Michael B.
When we give away Ron's stack of amplifiers back there, there's no hints.
There's no number big enough.
Michael, you figured that out, man? No way.
Congratulations, Michael.
No way. Well, there you go. And look at this. And see what makes it even cooler is he's a channel member. So see, we give back. We give back.
And I worked on his guitar.
Dude, you worked on his guitar. Michael B. is here. He's a regular viewer, watches all the time. He's a channel member.
Kurt. total, I'm going to say maybe 60 some, 70.
Oh, my goodness.
Total.
That's a lot of stuff. Yeah. Yeah, I'm assuming you guys have each other's info.
Yeah, because
you worked on his guitar.
Send it again, though, Michael, please.
There you go. Dude, that's...
Yeah,
that's
Kurt, cool. I have like, I don't know, 113, 117, somewhere around there, total.
We got to do a show where you show each one.
Well, I only have like 30-some here. Because I just didn't have the room. The rest are in storage, along with a bunch of the amps. Although, I may be bringing the other half of that mess of stack with the dual record for the other studio. So I may have that break that out for a little bit.
Okay, cool.
Thank you, Michael. Just got it. Kurt, no, I'm not a dealer or a store. I'm just a... guy who loves Jackson guitars.
There you go.
Grover should just give me that new polka dot one.
Well,
it'd be nice.
Come to the NAMM show. Maybe you'll run into him. So is the reason Jackson is your favorite? Is it because of Randy?
That is what started it. But once I played like. I had a Charvel. I got the Charvel Model 2 first.
Mm-hmm.
And I just fell in love with the neck on it. And then when I got my first Jackson, I was like, and it's just the neck profiles on them are just, it's perfect for my hand. And I love them. You know, and they're basically speed necks designed for players faster. I mean, somebody like Alex, you know, he should play one. But,
Skolnick.
Yeah.
Skolnick. Yeah, and the reason why I played his ID at the beginning of this is because he plays the Randy Remembered tributes during NAMM show. Alex plays a lot of those. That's why I played that. Here, I'll play it again for you guys just tuning in.
Hi, this is Alex Skolnick, and you're watching Johnny Bean TV.
Yeah.
So I gave you a segue there when I said Alex.
There you go. And actually, Alex did, he did try out for Ozzy.
Oh, I didn't know that.
When Alex was, well, hopefully he's told the story before. yeah.
Breaking news.
I don't think this is breaking news, although if it is, cool. I don't think it is, though. When I was working at the guitar shop in Berkeley, when Alex taught lessons in the back room, I remember him leaving to go audition for Ozzy Osbourne, and Alex at the time played a Les Paul, and my friend who also worked at the shop, I remember he put in, see, look at this, Neil, those of you that are brand new here, yeah, every time I mention a name and it's somebody I know or I have a clip from, I always play it. I remember my friend at the shop had installed Seymour Duncan pickups into the Les Paul for Skolnick when he was going to audition for Ozzy. So now this is where I play the clip with Seymour Duncan, although I cannot find it. Because we have so... Oh, here it is. Here, right here.
There we go.
Hi, guys. Seymour here at the NAMM 2019 with Johnny Bean. We're having a good time, and enjoy.
Yes. Yes, everybody, Seymour Duncan pickups. They're the best.
They are the best. They're definitely the best.
But you know, even working on guitars, what got me into that was the whole Wayne Charvel and Grover Jackson. You know, and when I first started doing it in 85, 84, 85, you know, I had dreams of coming up with the next guitar that we were going to see on MTV all the time. Because,
mm-hmm.
I mean, in the 80s, man, it was Charvel and Jackson, what most of those guys played, then Kramer.
Kramer.
But, you know.
I was playing the Kramer then.
Yeah. And it was like, I mean, I can't tell you how, I mean, let's see, the Tears Are Falling video from Kiss. Was that Bruce Kulick? I think that
not sure.
In the chat.
Ask the chat. Actually, I'm Facebook friends with his wife.
Are you? Okay.
We could ask her. But I've met Bruce Kulick a few times. He's cool, man.
In the Tears Are Falling video.
40 Grit says yes. Chris King says he thinks so.
Okay. He was playing a Charvel Model 2 that was like, I think, a purple, light purple metallic with like a triangle graphic on it coming from the neck back past the pickup. But it was a Charvel Model 2. I mean, everywhere you look, you saw Jackson, Charvel, Kramer, Jackson, Charvel, Kramer. And it's not that I don't like Kramer. I do. It's just when it comes personal preference neck wise, the Charvels and the Jacksons had the neck that I liked.
Mm-hmm. And that's what it's all about is because you play the thing.
Mm-hmm.
So if it feels good, it is good, right?
That's right. That's right.
There you go.
So I mean, you know, because of Randy and the whole story behind it is why I bought the first one. Let's put it that way. But after that, it was like, well, I wasn't just buying it because of Randy. I was buying it because I liked him. Mm-hmm. You know, then in 87, I had the ESP M1 Custom. And when I got that, that became my main guitar we played. And I played in the studio. And when we were on our tours, that's what I played. And the Charvels were like backup guitars.
That's cool, man. Wait a minute. Michael B is saying it could only be 9 different guesses with the hints I gave you. So that means they were pretty good hints. Even I was getting confused.
That's right, Lewis. Bernie did it. And then Brad Gillis. And then George was actually hired and did sound checks with the band.
Mm-hmm.
And then the day Jakey did the audition, Ozzy hired him on the spot. Jake walks out of the audition talking to George. Ozzy walks up to George and says, "You're fired."
Oh, no.
Right in front of Jake. So it was interesting, but again, you fall into that trio, you know, Randy, Eddie, and George.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, you know, I was there in 78, well, 78. I could have went. That's that woulda, shoulda, coulda moment. I wish I was.
Yeah.
I really, really wish I woulda went.
Raymond, Johnny Bean, are you going to show the Randy photo from Instagram? Randy, which one? On your Instagram?
Cool. Raymond, I got to see these photos.
Let me find it. Where is it? Oh, there's Skolnick.
and Raymond, ask Amanda to get a hold of me on Messenger, please.
Let's see. Okay, I'm on your Instagram right now. I'm looking. I don't see one. Did you send me a message? I'm looking at your Instagram right now. I don't see. Oh, wait. Wait, let's see what he says. I don't see a photo unless you messaged me. I don't see a photo on your profile. I only see like 10 photos. I don't know. Feel free to text the photo in or you can if you can message it through Instagram, you can do that. Or wait, maybe you did my other account. Let me see. I've got about 35 different accounts. Oh, My batteries are dying on that. Nope, I don't see it. I don't see it. Feel free to text. Text that number. You've texted stuff in before, I know. Feel free to text into that number, 415-952-3263. Yeah. It's there under a different photo. Oh. Okay. Under a different photo. Oh, you mean under all the... like the front of the book photo? Okay, well, it's really small. Let me see. Is that the one? Or is it this?
MPN, that's the company. Cool Pics. That's the one you're talking about.
Cool Pics? I know those. I know those ones. Okay, here's a photo right here. Here's one that, Raymond took. But yeah, it's really small. But here. This one. I mean, you can, I mean, obviously you can tell it's Randy.
Yeah. And the white Concorde. Although he was the only one that actually called it the Concorde.
Really?
Yeah, because that's where the design came from.
Mm-hmm.
And when they did the black one, it kind of had the wings still like that, the shape. And when they cut it, he said, Grover just grabbed it and cut it. And he said, Randy's like,
hmm. Let's see. What should we do? Should we go? Yeah, we can go another 8 minutes. We can make it two.
Okay.
Make it 2 hours. By the way, you guys.
Good.
If you guys are brand new here or whatever, we're doing this again tomorrow night. We do a show called Talking Guitars, 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 Pacific, and it'll be us. And we can talk more Randy guitars tomorrow. We can continue it, you know.
But hey, put a poll in the chat and see if they actually like this. About Randy, like, should we continue it, or whatever.
Do you like this show? Yes. Oh, hang on. There we go. All right, there's a poll in the chat for you guys. The question is, do you like the Randy Rhoads content? I think they do.
Talk more Van Halen.
Everybody vote now. We got 51 50s here tonight. Oh, wait, wrong show. Hey, you know, we might talk some Rat Pack and some Sinatra at some point. See, that's where the Saturday nights is cool, because the Saturday nights is more loose and we can talk, who cares? We can talk anything. And
loose,
you know,
sink ships.
Well, I know. You hear that, Chris King? Look at all those loose lips.
You're gonna sink the ship, man. I did say ship.
What do you guys think? Yes? You must have said yeah. There you go. Cool. Oh wait, Raymond. Uncle Raymond is saying click on the EVH photo to the left. There's many. Oh, okay. It's a carousel. That one? Well, those are all... Oh, the first one? Oh, I got it. Oh, no way. Oh. You ready, Ron?
Yeah.
You ready? Dude. Okay, here's Raymond's. Oh, I even liked that this photo. It says my name on there. Look at this. You've never seen this.
There we go. Cool.
Trying to get it to focus.
Yeah, because that almost looks like the reverse polka dot, white with the black dots.
Here, let's do this. If I screenshot it, we can get it. There we go.
Cool.
That's one of Raymond's photos. Right on, man.
I like it.
It's still a little blurry, but I think you can see it. There you go. Very cool. Very cool. Right on. All right. Okay. I think we only got a few minutes left. So you guys, thank you so much for tuning in.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
And we'll do another one of these. I mean, I want to do more of these. I mean, not just Randy Rhoads. I want to do more other subjects, other guitar players, other musicians, you know?
Jim Simmons has a thing there.
This, let's see, this one?
Yeah. He took out on his Marshall cabinets, he changed the Marshall speakers with Alnico. Is that the name of them?
Alnico pick?
Yeah, because he wanted pickups? That higher. Pick speakers. It started with an A.
Not sure. In the chat, what speakers start with an A? I don't know. Anyway.
So that's where that sound came from. Aztec? Something like that.
Alter?
No.
What happened to Laz? He has like 20 speakers in his room there on the floor.
Altec speakers, I think that's what they were.
Altec?
Yeah.
Lewis says Altec.
Okay.
Yeah, Altec.
He put those in, and they had
Altec, Chuck. Everybody said Altec. Look, everybody said Altec.
They had a brighter tone sound to them.
Uh-huh. And that's where his tone came from.
Yeah, or the tone he liked. Drew, the drummer, always said that whenever Randy played, he was louder than God.
On stage?
Yeah.
On stage. Yeah. Well, shows back then were super loud. Yeah. Yeah. Well, hey, yeah, we can talk more about that. We'll definitely do another one of these. I mean, I don't know if it'll be weekly, but we'll let you guys decide in the chat, you know. Let us know.
Yeah, look, Johnny, you can see the switch there. Where the input jack is, the switch is right up from it.
Right above that. Yeah, yep. I see it. Yeah. Oh, that's cool.
Then on the white Concord, it was up above the first pickup, the neck pickup, but on top of the body.
Hmm. Oh, that's interesting. Yeah, that's very interesting.
Because he used a switch like a kill switch is how he did it.
Yeah. Well, you would hear that.
Mm-hmm.
You would hear that in a lot of his stuff. Very cool. Right on, dudes. Well, hey, Ron Gunner, we'll have to have you back sometime, man.
How about tomorrow?
Tomorrow? Okay. We'll do another show tomorrow. Right on. Well, hey, channel members, thank you so much for your support of these shows. Thank you. Thank you very much. You guys are awesome.
Just thank everybody for tuning in, man.
Thank you for tuning in. And if you're brand new here, which I'm assuming we have some new people here, I'm just assuming that, consider subscribing to the channel. We're looking to get to 12K YouTube subscribers. So we can do that.
I was very nervous, people, talking to you. Mm-hmm. I was nervous myself. I kept looking at the clock, like 6 o'clock. Man, 4 more hours. And then 7 o'clock, 3 more hours. So I jumped on Call of Duty and let some of my aggression out.
Oh, man. And Laz was so nervous, he never came back.
he's showing that unit, so.
Oof. Oh, my gosh. Yeah. See you guys. Yeah, so we'll do another show tomorrow. We do a show called Talking Guitars, and we'll talk, obviously, guitars, you know, guitar news, you know, and we'll, you know, we can continue the Randy stuff. We do a show Saturday nights called Stratterday Night. We have one last thing to show here.
Saturday night, anything goes except keep your clothes on.
Anything goes Saturday nights. We have a great time. Hey, Johnny, it's Neil. I found this Blizzard of Oz road case on Craigslist about 10 years ago. I think it's the one from the photo with Randy. Have you seen this?
No, but it sounds like I won it.
Well, this is just a photo that he sent in.
Oh, man.
But he says he saw that on Craigslist 10 years ago, and he thinks it's that, the one in the photo back there.
Did you buy it?
Look what it says. Does that make sense?
I got to have that.
Would you know that?
Well, I mean, it could be, but it also could be someone stenciled and made one just to get extra money, too. Mm-hmm. I mean, that would be hard to tell.
You never know.
Oh, Neil, you bought it and you still have it. There you go.
Really? Wait a minute. No way. Neil, Neil, you got to jump on the show with us sometime. Maybe you can show it to us.
I'm taking donations for the studio if you want to send that my way.
There you go. He says it is the original.
Cool.
Oh, no way, man. No way. You'll have to jump on with us sometime and we'll have to look at it.
I'm going to have to look at Craigslist.
Yeah. Robbins. Rob Hines. Rob Hines, 69, new channel member. Thank you so much, Rob. Cool.
Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, man. Way. Yeah, man. Let's do that soon. Let's send me a message, okay? I know we're on Facebook. Send me a message on Facebook, and we'll set something up. All right.
Good on you, everybody.
Yes. All right. All right. We'll see you guys tomorrow night. Thanks for watching.
Be good. Thank you.
Smash that thumbs up on your way out. Okay.
Break the keyboard.
Yeah. Smash. All right. I'll play a couple channel IDs, then we'll get out of here. Thank you for watching, everybody.
You need to get one from Ozzy, man.
I need to get one. Somebody get me one. All right, see you guys tomorrow, Johnny Bean TV. Bye-bye.
Hi, this is Alex Skolnick, and you're watching Johnny Bean TV.
Ready?
Ready.
Hi, this is Andy Summers, and you're watching Johnny Bean TV.
Hi, this is Dweezil Zappa, and you're watching Johnny Bean TV. Hey, it's Corey Feldman, you're watching Johnny Bean TV, I guess. All right,